Whoa, oh, oh. When there's love, love, love in the air, you see people making faces like they just don't care. Because love is simple, love is free, love is there for you and me. When there's love, love, love in the air, love, when there's love, love, love in the air, love, when there's love, love, love in the air, love, when there's love, when there is love. When there's love, 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 and there's love, when there's love, 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 and there's love, when there's love, 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 and there's love, when there's love. In the air, you start to notice all the people loving everywhere. Because love is happy and love is kind, love is yours and love is mine. When there's love, love, love it is love, and there's love, love, love it is love, and there's love, love, love it is love, and there's love. When there is love, when there's love.
Especially when I know I'm not. Make me feel good when I hurt so bad. Barely getting mad, I'm so glad I found you. I love being around you. You make it easy. It's easy as one, two. There's only one thing to do. Three words for you. There's only one way to say those three words, and that's what I'll do. I love you. Give me more love from the very start. Piece me back together when I fall apart. Tell me things you never even tell your closest friends. Make you feel good when I hurt so bad. Best that I've had, I'm so glad I found you. I love being around you. You make it easy. It's easy as one, two, one. There's only one thing to do. Three words for you. I love you. There's only one way to say those three words. That's what I do.
In every I love the shape of your mouth. I love the taste of your lips. I love the way you pull me into you and I melt when you're holding my hips. I love the scar on your chest.
Michael, I've known you for nearly 13 years now. I promise to always be by your side, to love and cherish you.
You're a kind of drug, the kind that I need.
I promise to always support you, your decisions, to make sure to give you space when you need it.
We can't get any better than this. You've stolen me with your perfect kiss, and I know.
Arthur, thank you for accepting me and loving me for who I am. Thank you for always trying your hardest to provide the best of everything you can to me. I will commit myself to never give up and stand by you in good and bad times, and will support you unconditionally to make your dreams and goals come true.
Bride and the groom will entering the Shrine Hall and the room, celebration of marriage between Ethelie and Michael Kawano Suliawan, today, 12 July 2013, place at Jasmine Room, Ayana Resort. Dear families, friends, and we have come together in the sight of Triple Gem for joining in marriage of Arthur Lee and Michael Kawano. Before we start the blessing ceremony, I invite the groom father, Master Roger Lee, to light the blue candle. The blue candle, symbol of devotion. Next, I invite Mrs. Kuang Nguyen, the groom grandmother, to light the yellow candle. Yellow is symbolized of wisdom. Next, I invite bride's father, Master Rudianto Suliawan, to light the white candle. White is symbol of purity. Next to bride mother, Mrs. Yoko Kawano, to light on the orange candle. Orange is a symbol of enthusiasm. And I, as a priest today, will light on the red candle. Red is a symbol of loving kindness. Arthur and Michael, please stand up in the front of the Buddha shrine. My assistant will light on the incense stick. We will throw him. Please follow me word by word. We will do respect to the Buddha, the teacher, Dharma, the teaching, and the Sangha as the community of holy disciples. Arahang.
Arahang. Sammasambuddho.
Sammasambuddho.
Bhagava.
Bhagava.
Buddham.
Buddham.
Bhagavantam.
Bhagavantam.
Abhivadeni.
Yes, Buddha body, giving respect to the Buddha, the teacher. Swakato
Bhagavata
Dhammo
Dhammam
Namasami.
Namasami.
Yes, Buddha body, giving respect to the teacher. Supatipanno.
Supatipanno.
Bhagavato.
Bhagavato.
Savaka Sangho.
Savaka Sangho.
Sangham.
Sangham.
Namami.
Namami.
Yes, everybody, you can respect the community of holy disciples. Okay, Arthur, you will declare your vow first, yeah? And now declare your vow. Namo.
Namo
Tassa
Tassa
Bhagavato
Bhagavato
Arahato
Arahato
Sama Sambuddhasa
Sama Sambuddhasa.
Okay, Arthur, please declare your vows today.
I ask all present to be my witness that I, Arthur, have accepted Michael to be my wife. I promise to respect, to be gentle, faithful, and to protect, love, and care for her as my wife, in mind, word, and deed. May God and Triple Gen guide me.
And Michael, you can remember what Arthur has said, his vow today for you. Please follow me word by word first. Namo.
Namo.
Tassa.
Tassa.
Bhagavato.
Bhagavato.
Arahato.
Arahato.
Sama Sambuddhasa.
Sama Sambuddhasa.
Okay, let's declare your vow in the front of the all the guests here.
I ask all present to be my witness, that I, Michael, have accepted Arthur to be my husband. I promise to respect, to be gentle and faithful, and to protect, love, and care for him as my husband. In mind, word, and deed, may God and Triple Gen guide me.
Okay, that's your vows today. Giving and receiving the ring. I invite Arili to come to the shrine. Please give me the wedding ring. Thank you very much. Let us pray first. Concentrate. God of steadfast love, we ask of you that the love between Arthur and Michael always to remain unbroken as the ring which the couple will give and receive in your own name. Okay, you are facing each other. Take the small ring. Take the ring finger of Michael. Please say this, Michael.
Michael,
I give you this ring, as a symbol of marriage,
as a symbol of marriage,
and all of the vow,
all the vow
which we have made today,
with
all that I am,
and all that I have,
I honor you. Forever. Okay. Please say this, Arthur.
I
give you this ring as a symbol of marriage and of the vows which we have made today. With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you forevermore. Yes, entering the ring. Next is blessing. I will bind the thumb. This is the symbol of love between you. The red color is symbol of love in Buddhism. I invite Ms. Yoko Kawano and Puong Yen to cover the bride and groom with the yellow cloth. So next, I recite the Paritta. Lots of hope inside Paritta for the goodness of you, to both. After finish the Paritta, I'll say Sadhu. Arthur and Michael, please say Sadhu, 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 3 times, okay? Let's concentrate. Ratanathaya nubhavena, Ratanathaya tejasa, Dukha roga baya vera sota satu cupadawa aneka antaraya pivina satu ase satu jaya sidi danang labang soti bagyang sukang balang siri ayu cewano cabo gang budi caya sawa satawa saca ayu ca jiwa sidi bawan tute Bhavatu sabha mangalang rakantu sabha devata sabha buddhanu bhavena sada soti bhavantu te Bhavatu sabha mangalang rakantu sabha devata sabha dhammanu bhavena sada soti bhavantu te Bhavatu sabha mangalang rakantu sabha devata sabha sanghanu bhavena sadha soti bhavantu te sadhu. They say sadhu 3 times. Sadhu. Thank you. So I will give you a little speech. What is wedding in perspective of Buddhism? Michael, Arthur, so after leaving from this room, as a Buddhist, you will become husband and wife. The Buddha itself already said, when inside your heart you have love, and after that you can make the wedding like what you did today, the Buddha already declared that through the wedding we can reach the, they call it the Wadley, the highest Wadley happiness. The Buddha said, through the wedding, based on love inside your heart, you will get the highest purpose. Humans actually are egoist, difficult to share to each other, because egoist, there's sometimes when somebody blame, they will not feel guilty. When you have love inside your heart, through the love, the feeling of love inside yourself, you can easily share the thing you have with your partner. Even you are not happy when you see your partner, you can feeling happy also. So through the wedding, we will practice how to share, how to think of others. So through this condition, we can reach the more higher condition. Through the feeling of love, through the, this your wedding, two families that are different, they don't know each other, they will become very close relative. You can understand what I mean? The big family from both sides, actually not knowing each other because of your relationship, they will become very close family, sometimes more close than brother and sisters. So the Buddha said, when you already have a commitment in your vow, you already declare, I'll be the husband and my close today, I'll be the wife of Arthur. As soon as possible, four qualities inside you, you must make it one. Actually, similarize, harmonize between each other. The first, the Buddha said, called religion, sadha in Balinese word. Sadha is religion. How do you can, how you think of the life, the concept, everything. In Buddhism, we didn't know the dogma. You must believe this, no? Because the Buddha, you must always search by yourself, find it, and then you will find, oh, this is good for me, this not so not good for me, you just follow the good one. So harmonize between you now, make the concept the same. Whatever Arthur think about life, what is life? So Michael must think the same. Whatever Michael concept, so Arthur also try, what is Michael think of, about thing? So you will try to similarize it as soon as possible. No concept that make you quarrel and debate till very long. So through the similarize of the concept, you can passing this we call the sadha, the religion for the public opinion. Yes? Number one, we call the morality. We call it sila. As a Buddhist, we have five precepts. Every moment of life, you always think not to kill, not to steal, not to do sexual misconduct. So sexual misconduct in this moment already very strict to you because you already a partner, you already declared it before. When you already have relationship, now Arthur already have wife, Michael already got husband, Arthur. So every girl in this world except Michael is prohibited for you. And also every man in this world except Arthur is prohibited to you if you want to make this percept purity. So be loyal each other. This is the precept number three. Number four, not telling a lie. And number four, drink alcohol not until drunk. Because you are now in modern life, we take alcohol, no problem, but until you're ready, oh, I'll be unconscious after take another more, so stop it, not until drunk. No narcotics. So these five precepts, not to kill, not to steal, not to do sexual misconduct, not telling a lie, not alcohol and narcotic make you trouble. Number three, we call chaga, the kindness, the generosity. If you are so generous, want to help people, want to help the country, always think of your partner. When you are not the same, that are too generous and too not generous, must take the middle way. The generous make it less, and then the ungenerous make it more generous. So try to be the same in the family. When one do the good thing, their partners must feel happy. If you do good thing and your partner unhappy, it's not useful. Trouble in the family. So number four, we call it wisdom, panya, because you are, your relationship make lots of family. Always think of your partner. Whatever you do that make your partner unhappy, you will make the big family unhappy. Most of the people, most of your family now watching you. When you are happy, they are happy. When you are not happy, so they are unhappy either. With the wisdom, we will always think our family. So try, make a never-ending commitment. Similarize. Sometime maybe shocking, but try. You already choose. Wedding is a choice, not an assignment. Because you already choose, do commitment. Okay, that's my words for today. Hope it's useful. Okay. Please, mother, open it again, this yellow room. As a symbol of your support, open this one. Yeah, okay. Yes, thank you very much. I accept this. According to the vow you have made, I now proclaim your marriage by the authority invested in me as a Buddhist Pandita in Bali, and the name of Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha, I proclaim Arthur Lee and Michael Kawano Suliawan to be husband and wife. Arthur, you may kiss your wife. One more. Long, so the photographer can take it more beautiful. Arahang sama sambuddho bhagava buddhang bhagavantang abhivademi. Yeah, Buddha Bodhi, giving respect to the teacher. Swakato bhagavata Dhammo, Dhammang, Namasami. Bodhi Bodhi to the teaching. Supatipanno, Bhagavato, Sawaka Sangho, Sanggang, Namami. The body and giving respect to the community of holy disciple. Arthur and Michael, I invite you to signing the certificate of marriage and also from our government.
Thanks for coming, everybody. pull it down. Hey, that's a pretty good idea. I'll give you the move. To do.
Like deja vu, baby.
Suavemente. Yeah. Now we'd like to welcome the bridal party. The maid of honor, Ray Kawano, and best man, Ari Lee.
JJ Liu and Jeremy Magalong.
Kim Nguyen and Tim Smith.
Natalie Gummerson and Ryan Prasad.
Mari Suginoshita and Patrick Chow.
Miyuki Hara and Toby Fong.
Yolanda Siswanto and Peter An.
Let's now welcome the families of the bride and groom. The sister of the groom, Ashley Stoltz. The father of the groom, Roger Lei. The grandfather, Tao Fan Lei. And the grandmother, Fung Nguyen.
The mother of the groom, Michelle Tan Nu. The father of the groom, Stephen Stoltz.
The brothers of the bride, Ryu Kawano Sulyawan and Ricky Kawano Sulyawan. The mother of the bride, Yoko Kawano. And the father of the bride, Rudy Sulyawan.
And now, after 12 years, finally, the guests of honor,
the bride and the groom,
the Mr. and the Mrs.,
Michael and Arthur!
Arthur and I would like to thank everyone for gathering here tonight to celebrate our special day. We are very blessed to have such a special friends and family traveling all over the world to be here tonight. Mom, Dad, thank you so much for organizing a fabulous wedding for Arthur and I. To have a wedding in Ayana has been our dream, and we really sincerely appreciate for your kindness. I also want to take this opportunity to thank you for being a great parent. I know you've made a lot of sacrifices to give the best life to me and my sibling. I will remember all the guidance you have given me when I build my own family with Arthur. Although I'm moving to Hong Kong, I will always come back to Jakarta. So please don't even consider remodeling my room to be your second workout room, like what you did to Ryu. To Arthur's parents and grandparents, thank you for raising Arthur to be kind, successful, and hardworking man. Actually, Arthur made me say this. But I know that I will have a happy and loving family with Arthur. I also don't know anybody who can handle me so patiently as Arthur. Special thank you to Arthur's groomsmen and my bridesmaid who helped me carry my 10-kilogram dress during my two weddings. To all the people who was involved in putting this wedding together, your hard work is sincerely appreciated. This day would not be possible without you. Thank you.
Okay, the bride and groom are going to sit down and dinner is going to start, so please go back to your seats and enjoy the meal.
Wise men say all the fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you.
gentlemen, I would like to call up the maid of honor, Ray Kawano, and the best man, Ari Lee, to give their speech. Please give him a round of applause.
Papa saya bilang ke saya untuk speech dalam bahasa Indonesia karena kita sedang ada di Bali. Gak bisa dengar? Bisa dengar sekarang? Papa saya bilang ke saya untuk speech dalam bahasa Indonesia karena kita sedang ada di Bali. No problem, saya bilang. Akhirnya, sebagai orang Indonesia yang baik, saya pakai Google Translate. Ketika saya latihan di depan papa saya, dia melihat saya dengan kasihan. Mungkin jangan deh, dedek. Oleh karena itu, mohon maaf. Maaf apabila speech ini saya akan bawakan dalam bahasa Inggris. Hey. Bapak-bapak, ibu-ibu, saudara-saudara sekalian. Thank you so much for being here today. I'm so very excited to be standing here before you on this very, very special occasion. My name is Ray, best known as Maiko's annoying, needy, and freakishly controlling sister. My brother Ryu reminded me that this is a toast to my sister and Arthur, and not to go on a tangent about myself. Which, as all of you may or may not know, is us Kawano Suliawan's favorite pastime. So I will control myself and try to keep it short and simple. I was trying to think of a sweet story about Maiko and Arthur, and the one that came to mind was the story of how the two met. I was 11 when I first heard this story. My sister sat me down, batted her eyes as she began replaying the scene of awkward Arthur coming up to her armed with a jar in his hand and said what apparently was the smoothest and sexiest line in the Banana Slugs history, "Are these your peanuts?" When I proceeded to tell her that he was probably sincerely looking for the peanut owner, my sister firmly reassured me, "No, Ray, that is how boys tell you they like you." Boy was I upset when years passed and still no boy inquired about my peanuts. That is only one of many examples I could give you of my sister's teachings. Microwave broccoli is an actual dish. It's okay to call someone 10 times if they don't pick up the phone. If they love you, they will hold your bag. These are the lessons that, for better or for worse, have shaped the person I am today. I'm not sure if she got these lessons from her favorite book, How to Win Friends and Influence People. But seeing the number of loved ones gathered here today, these lessons have apparently worked well for her. Chi, thank you so much for putting up with me. As some of you may or may not know, or have heard from various sources, I am not the easiest person to deal with. But my sister has tolerated me for the past 23 years, and I'm so, so sorry, because I'm sure it's felt much, much longer. I'm sorry for not letting you hang out with your friends and accompanying you on your dates, but in my defense, it's not my fault you made me have a sister complex. You are the best sister, mother, role model, and best friend a girl could have. And I thank mom and dad every day for giving birth to me in a world with you. I'm always so amazed by how caring and selfless you are, and I truly don't know where or who I would be without you. The day is always a little bit brighter, food a little bit tastier, jokes a little bit funnier when I'm with you. From the way you were snoring last night, no one would have ever known what a beautiful bride you are. Surely the most beautiful bride I know, and I'm not just saying that because I know we look alike. Arthur, congratulations. You are now blessed with the honor of sharing the burden of me with my sister. Please take good care of her and level out her crazies with her zen-like aura. Remember, Quinta is trained to kill. I know that I never show it, and I certainly have never said it, except for that one time in Sonoma, but I'm so excited to be gaining you as my brother. Welcome to the family. I wish you both all the best, and Chi, may the future bring you all the happiness that I've gained from having you as my sister. So if everyone could please raise your glass to a lifetime of happiness, I cannot wait to move into your spare bedroom.
Cheers. Cheers.
Everyone, I apologize in advance. I'm not really a talker. Arthur is the only person I know that would force his best man to deliver not one, but two speeches about him in a two-week speech. I guess I really shouldn't be surprised, considering he has been historically his happiest when people are gathered in a room talking about him, but I guess that's what you get. So, I know my previous speech veered a little more to the negative side, so between then and now, I've tried my hardest to come up with mostly positive things to say about the man. Unfortunately, I couldn't, so instead I'm forced to repeat most of what I said. So, bear with me. Before we start, I'd like to congratulate the Lay and Suliwan families again. Who thought that you could possibly repeat the wonderful experience just a few days ago? Everything has gone picturesque. And Michael? You look even more stunning today. You have really perfected that I'm clearly much too good for my husband look. And thank you to everyone who traveled near and far to share this day with the bride and groom. I don't think I'm going out on a limb when I say we're all here for the same reason. To witness, in person, Arthur Lay crying on stage again. It didn't happen, unfortunately. So, sorry, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Ari Lee, and I'm part of Arthur's friends from Hong Kong. When Arthur first asked me to be his best man, I was initially taken back. It's really the highest honor that you can really give another man. But then I quickly worried about what in the world I was going to say during this speech. You know, what could I tell this group about Arthur that you don't already know for yourself? I'm not a sibling, so you don't have any of those classic Arthur beat me up and now I love him stories. And it's also incredibly hard to shed new light on a guy who never really stops talking about himself to begin with. It soon occurred to me that I should elicit the help of his closest friends and ask for some classic Arthur stories. I got responses, all very similar in nature, and they involve him with his famous googly eyes at the end of a night sleeping on a couch of a club or a Denny. Now, I'm not going to tell those stories tonight, because not because they're bad, but because he holds grudges and because they make me look pretty bad myself. So I guess what I'm left with is to describe him a bit to the crowd. What can we say about him as a man? Well, he has some fantastic traits, traits parents are proud of and traits that friends look for in their friends. The only problem is that one trait Arthur does not have is moderation. So let's take a look at how this permeates through his personality. For one, we know he's a confident guy, self-assured, never lacking in self-belief. It's exactly the trait you want in a colleague or an employee. He's willing to try things and really put himself out there in any setting, personal or professional. Without moderation, however, you got a guy telling every old colleague he runs into that their ex-boss says he's the best hire he's ever made. They don't come any better than Arthur. The guy likes to drink. There's a monster in his belly that lives off of, wait, nope. We're not telling those stories tonight. Sorry, no, sorry, sorry. So what else do we know about Arthur? We know he's a smart guy. Anyone that spends a couple minutes with him can quickly glean this information. I'm not talking about how he acts like the resident expert after reading one Wikipedia article. I'm talking about how smart he sounds when he discusses things he really takes seriously. Arthur speaking for an exchange, for example. It's like listening to Rain Man count cards. I remember when he was telling me about this black box trading strategy that was going to allow him to retire early. Long euro, short yen, thin spread, heavy flow. Now, it is besides the point that he lost the equivalent of a down payment on the house using this strategy, he sounded very smart when he told all of his friends about it. One thing that is abundantly clear is that Arthur is grounded. You can throw him anywhere and he lands on his feet, like a cat. does what the locals do. Doesn't matter where you are or what you need, he's got a guy. You're in Vietnam and you need a suit, he's got a guy. You need a maid in Hong Kong, he's got a girl. And he's glad to refer this person to anyone in need. Listen, this guy grew up in the US, and within weeks, he completely adjusted to his life in Asia. He went from eating In-N-Out burgers and Mexican food in the mission to eating congee with kidneys and liver, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Now, lacking moderation, he ate so much organ meat, he was diagnosed with gout at 26 years old. And that maid that he referred everyone to, it turns out she was robbing him and his friends blind. What else? We know he's a proud man, and it's a great thing. Everyone should care, both physical and reputational appearance. Look at him. He's a walking endorsement for CrossFit. Just ask him. His bow tie? Next month's issue of GQ. His pants? So tight, he looks like he's on his way to yoga. How else does this manifest itself in his actions? Well, I guess there's the fact that he will always post pictures on Facebook about his travel, but only if he gets upgraded to business. Check it out. Or how about he refuses to play any sport with friends unless he feels confident he can win? Arthur, you want to hang out? Sure. You want to play basketball? Ooh, I got a conference call. How about that time he lost his watch, or should I say his watch got stolen, and he quickly bought a fake replacement? In classic Arthur fashion, he would accept compliments on a fake watch. He would talk about its complicated movement. What happened when he lost his fake watch? Well, he walked around Hong Kong saying that the real ballers don't wear watches. They want the clean wrist, bro. So, how did I get to know him so well? For the past 4 years, we've been friends in the social pressure cooker of an environment that is Hong Kong. We met in our mid-20s when the only important thing was where we were going out that evening. Where were we drinking? We drinking tonight? 7 days a week. Working the next day? Let's just order food instead. Saving up and planning for the future? Nah. Commitment? You couldn't get this guy to stay in one place for two drinks. But then something happened. Suddenly the guy got serious. He started looking for new jobs and he shook up his career. He moved on from the only workplace that he knew. He started saving up and not spending frivolously. He started Skyping 30 times a day and going to art jamming sessions. For God's sakes, this guy almost up and moved to Singapore and left everything he knew about his life behind. And why this change? It's Michael, of course. It wasn't that she was demanding the change, it was that he wanted to do these things on his own for her. When I finally met Michael, I was instantly won over and realized why Arthur was so compelled to do this self-improvement campaign. When I got to know her, I was able to put my finger on what made her special. And in reality, the only woman in the world that Arthur can be with. It is obvious that she makes him happy, but more importantly for us, she's the one that keeps us in check. In effect, she is the one that instills moderation, thus only bringing out the good traits and saving us from the rest. And as a friend, I can say there is nothing better to see. And I ask that not that we drink, but that we ganbei to the lovely couple.
One of the bride's very special friends, JJ Leo, has put together a very precious video to turn your attention to the screen.
Hey, babe.
Babe?
Yep, Pat's here.
Oh my God, babe. Jay, this shoe or this shoe?
I like the beige one.
I like this shoe. Michelle, do you know Foodie Chat? It's so amazing.
Babe, I'm not gonna hold your bag, babe.
Hey, babe.
Hey, babe. Babe. What are you doing, babe?
Babe, babe. Babe, babe.
Babe. Babe, no. I've got, babe, I'm with the guys.
Babe.
Babe, no.
Babe. 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 Hello. Babe.
Hey, babe.
Have you checked out that email from...
Did you call the wedding planner?
What's our name of our wedding organizer?
No, babe.
What? Well, I didn't hear you. Can you say that again?
Oh my god, my god. Have you guys seen that shit girl saying video? Oh my god. Me and Ray thinks that Jay. Totally looks like Michael.
I need to go to the bathroom.
Now?
Now.
Michael, babe, is Mika gonna sleep on the bed?
On the bed. And you're sleeping on the floor.
Yeah, I'm at the office, babe. Just finished my CrossFit workout. CrossFit, babe. CrossFit. CrossFit workout. CrossFit workout today. CrossFit. It's about the strength, not about the look. Crazy wad today, babe. CrossFit is the way to go. The wad was crazy. What's your wad?
Yeah, I'm so excited.
What about?
Hold on. Babe? Babe? I'm talking to someone right now.
Babe, I'm not holding your bag, babe.
Oh, Leah, oh, so okay, sorry. Okay. I am so excited. Babe.
Oh, wow! I thought you're really strong!
Thanks, JJ. It's the CrossFit.
Oh, those are really cute glasses.
Thanks, I just bought them. Wayfarers.
Hello?
Oh, hi, honey. Hey, are you still gonna be sleeping over tonight?
Yeah. Oh, but wait, Jay. Mika's gonna be lonely.
Again?
Babe,
stop calling me, babe. Babe, I'm really busy.
Of the bride and groom would now like to honor the couple with some songs and some music. So please turn your attention to the stage in the back, and our first singer of the evening will be Elsie Mullers.
I know you haven't made your
instead please welcome Victor Hartono on the stage, who will sing a very, very special song from the bottom of his heart for the couple. And it will be in the special language of Japanese. Victor.
I promised Michael I'll sing the song in her wedding before. Actually told her this before Arthur even proposed. But I can imagine, I already imagine it in my head that Michael one day will marry Arthur in Bali. And I think this is the song that's appropriate for this occasion. It's called You're the Only from Masatoshi Ono.
I love you tonight. Toki ga tomareba ii ne. Nagare boshi kirameku. Omoi o tsutae. I love you tonight. Kimi dake ireba ii yo. Ima kokoro kirameku. Negai o kanae.
Put your hands together for the bridesmaids.
Woo! And this is Crazy in Love by Emily Sande.
Such a funny thing for me to try to explain how I'm feeling.
brand is the one to blame. Cause I know I don't understand. Cause now your love is doing when the notes hit. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your love's got me looking so crazy right now. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your touch got me looking so crazy right now. Got me hoping you paid me right now. Your kiss got me looking so crazy right now. Looking so crazy, your love's got me looking so crazy, your love. When I talk to my friends so badly, and we think he is licking what you did to me. Then his shoes don't even need to buy a new dress. You ain't there, ain't nobody else to impress. The way that you know what I gotta do is the beat of my heart's getting when I'm with you. And I still don't understand just how you're looking, do what no one else can. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your love's got me looking so crazy right now. Got me looking so crazy right now. Your kiss got me looking so crazy right now. Got me holding your page right now. Your kiss got me looking so crazy right now. Looking so crazy, your love's got me looking, got me looking so crazy, your love. Looking so crazy, your love.
This was just for you. We will have another very exciting video by one of Michael's special friends. The next video that will be shown have been produced by Mari and Miyuki with the help of all of their friends from all around the world. So please, let the video begin.
この前あったけどみんな、舞子ちゃんとは、さきな先生の、ピアノで一緒だ、ピアノじゃないけど、まあ、ピアノで一緒だったと思うんですけど、その時の印象は、ボイッシュだなっていう眼鏡かけてて、ズボンの似合う感じだったけど、この前にゆきちゃん結婚式に会った時には、すごく女性らしくなくて、結婚するって聞いて、あ、そうなるだろうなっていうのは思ってました。香港行ったら遊びに行かせてください。
あやこです。京香です。
京香ちゃん。
まいこちゃんは大人になって久しぶりに会った時にすごい綺麗になってたんですけど、中身はもう純粋な昔のままで、なんかいつもなんか会ってもほっとして昔のように戻れてお話ができるので嬉しいです。旦那さんとずっとお幸せにね。言葉じゃ伝えきれない、
much for this very special video. Michael, this is from all of your friends who couldn't be here today and some that have made it here. So thank you very much once again.
Ladies and gentlemen, Michael and Arthur are going to be cutting the cake right now. So please turn your attention up front, up here, to watch them cut the cake. Come on, everybody, make some noise. Cheer for the couple as they cut through the first
hand on top. They're cutting it, they're cutting it. Nice and coming down.
Seven layers to go through. Woo! There, halfway there.
Come on, you can do it. It's a very, very big cake.
There's a party going on right here. A celebration to last throughout the years.
Good job.
So bring your good times and your laughter too.
Michael and Arthur, can you please sit back down?
We're gonna party with you. Come on now.
Celebration. Of course, we'll get some more
pictures
in.
Let's all celebrate and have a good time.
Theo, where are you? Maybe please invite the brother of the bride, Rio, to come to the stage.
Let's celebrate. There's a party going on right here.
No, dude, I'm like standing by. So for this opportunity, on behalf of the family, I would like to thank everyone for coming to Michael and Arthur's wedding. I know it wasn't easy for everyone to come to Bali just for one wedding, but I think Arthur and Michael and also our families are very glad that you were able to make it. This beach and this wedding party is not just about Arthur and Michael. I think it's also an opportunity for them and their families to thank everyone that has supported and helped them throughout the years. So on behalf of the Suliwan family, the Lay family, and Michael and Arthur, thank you very much. みなさん、はじめまして。マイコの弟のリュウです。ちょっと日本語で、I'm good speaking Japanese、姉のマイコと、あと向こうのアーサーのために、遠くから来ていただいて、本当にありがとうございます。ここ数日、バリでは、ずっと雨が降ってたんですけども、今日は本当に天気が、良くなって、結婚式には最適な日になりました。本当に今までアーサーとマイクをサポートしていただき本当にありがとうございました。 and yeah, I guess that's it for me. Michael and Arthur, congratulations. Just want to tell everyone, I was that Michael in the video. I am not gay. I do have a girlfriend, a fiance. So yeah, don't ever try to approach me, from the back. Anyways, guys, that's it for the joke. Arthur and Michael is going to have their first dance.
Still swimming in me, so afraid to come close.
Ladies and gentlemen, and now a special surprise is planned. Please direct your attention to the screen in just one moment, and hopefully this will get you in the mood for the after party, which is going to be in the ballroom starting at 10:30. There will be cars and buggies bringing you to the ballroom, so make your way up to the front where you came in. But first, to get you ready into the party mood, please let the video begin. Con los terroristas.
I can't hear you. One, two, three. Three, two, one. Throw and fight, fight, fight. Three, two, one, go. Make some noise, ladies. Three, two, one.
Hi everyone, I just want to remind you that if you're not ready to go to bed, or even if you are, forget about it.
Let's go party! There's an after party at the ballroom, so it'll start at 10:30, or you can go now. You can go now and start partying. Keep the party going. Celebrate Maiko and Arthur all night long. Let's go!
Party people, make some noise now! 1, 2, 3, go! Boring! One more time, last chance. 1, 2, 3, go!
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, just a quick announcement. The after party is at the Ayana Ballroom. To make your way there, just go up to the lobby and our staff will be there to guide you towards the ballroom. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please make your way over to the Ayana Ballroom when you're ready, as we have the after party there. See you over and take care.
Pitbull, Naya, Neo, that's right.
I will not love you tonight. Give me everything tonight. For all we know, we might not get tomorrow. Let's do it tonight.
Don't care what they say or what kills me. Nothing is enough to love.
Let's do it tonight.
Somebody
sexy, tell them, hey, give me everything tonight. Give me everything tonight. Give me everything tonight. Give me everything tonight.
Excuse me, and I might drink a little more than I should tonight. And I might take you home with me if I could tonight. And baby, I'ma make you feel so good tonight.
Let's go to the beach, each, let's go get a wave. They say what they gonna say, have a drink, clink, found a Bud Light. Bad bitch like me, it's hard to come by. The Patron, oh, let's go get it down. The sound, oh, yes, I'm in the zone. Is it 2, 3, leave a good tip. I'ma blow all of my money and don't give
I'm on the floor.